What is going on, guys? And this is a video I should not have to make. It's a video I don't want to make, but I feel like I have to make. This is really starting to get me down. This is the whole Elsa Gate thing, if they call it. And if you're unfamiliar with what this is, prepare to be utterly disgusted and shocked by what is going on and what could potentially be going on to your children, if you have children too, because this is a big problem across YouTube and across parents not really paying attention, but we'll get to that in a minute. So first off, what is Elsa Gate? What does this mean? Maybe hearing this term thrown around, what does that mean? I don't really understand. Well, Elsa Gate is basically these videos or type of videos, if you want to call them that, that are going around that are very, very prevalent and popular on YouTube, getting millions and millions of views, being promoted by YouTube, being on the YouTube Kids app, and all that kind of stuff, which we'll get into in just a minute. But they're using characters like the Elsa character from Frozen, characters like Spider-Man, the Joker, very popular either superheroes or Disney characters or princesses or superheroes, anything that they know that kids glom onto. Frozen is just a perfect example of this because they use Elsa for fucking everything. She's a hot looking girl in a lot of videos. They have actresses dress up as her in next to nothing and make out with Spider-Man or drink pee. You may think I'm crazy here, but this is, just go ahead and take a look at some of these screen grabs here. I took just one search. Type in Spider-Man Elsa and pages and pages and pages of this shit comes up. And it's just a tip of the iceberg, guys. This goes on forever. Forever and ever. And are some of these videos lighthearted and actually kid-friendly? Sure. Not every one of these is awful. But the percentage is off the charts. And YouTube is not keeping tabs on this at fucking all. They claim to now be doing a better job. This was a problem in the past. They're working on fixing it now. But it's still happening. It's happening everywhere. These videos are fucking everywhere. Millions of views. Millions and millions of children watching videos like Joker pee prank versus Frozen Elsa in bath. Superheroes in real life. These are actual titles. Elsa, Frozen Elsa must pee. Spider-Man, Joker, Frozen Teddy toys on toilet. I'm just scrolling down a list here, guys. Frozen Elsa needs to pee. Spider-Man toilet prank. Superhero funny pranks. Baby pee on giant water slide with Elsa. Spider-Man Elsa fun kids toy. Superhero 3D clan animation. Another thing I'd like to point out here. Maybe wondering what these titles are and why they just seem so gibberishy. Like, let me read that one again. Baby pee on giant water slide with Elsa. Frozen Spider-Man, Elsa, fun, kids, toys, superhero 3D claymation. That is a quote. That is exactly what the title is. You may be like, well, how does that get, you know, that has a ton of views. How does something like that get a ton of views? Well, that title is them just working the YouTube algorithm because it takes into accordance of what's in not only the tags, but what's in the title. So what they're doing is they're getting these keywords that kids search for. They might search for water slide, obviously search for Elsa, for Spider-Man, for pranks, for animation, for cartoon, for nursery rhyme, for kid-friendly, you know, things like that. And they'll just put people are calling it a word soup. Just not even a sentence, not even a coherent thought, just Frozen, Elsa, nursery rhyme, toilet, pee, prank, Spider-Man. And put all those things in both the title and in the tags, and that'll rank that video higher than something that is actual, you know, kid-friendly content. And then because of these lewd, freaking sexualized, creepy fucking, you know, clickbait for children, they're getting this. And because they're getting the views, because they have the right tags, because they have the right titles, they're hitting these key terms that the YouTube algorithm is saying these are what's popular with this demographic. These videos are exploding, and they're making thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars off these videos. I can guesstimate on a video. Let's just take one up here. Let's see this, that Joker pee prank versus Frozen Elsa in bathtub is 8 months old and has generated 8.3 million views. That is insane. 8.3 million views. That's a million a month. That is probably close to $2,000, $3,000, if not more, depending on what the ad fill rate is and what their CPM is. But because I would have to guess it has tags that have to do with children, and has to do with Disney, and it has such a good view-like ratio, I would guess that their CPM on that is probably in the 2 to 3, possibly even higher now, dollars per 1,000 views. So that video with that CPM, with 8 million views, could have potentially made $30,000 in that 8 months. Potentially. This is all hypothetical. But that's not an unreasonable number at all to think that one video made off of peeing on a girl in a bathtub. And I'm showing a little clip of this now. This is really weird. Like, this is, if I had a child, I don't have any kids, but if I did, this is not something I would want them to be watching. And this is something that parents need to be aware of. You know, they put the kids down with the iPads, you see it all the time. Kids in the supermarket, kids on the go, kids in the backseat of the car, kids at home. They're attached to these tablets, to these phones, just as much as me and you are. And with this content, you would think that, you know, they would be safe. You know, that your mom might give you, or might give their 2-year-old their tablet and type in on the search, Frozen Elsa nursery rhyme. And the first video that comes up, they might put in front of the kid. It comes up, they watch it, it's all good and whatever. But what they may not do, and a lot of parents I feel like aren't doing, because these videos have that many views, these aren't adults watching these videos. What they're doing is most likely watching the first video or two with the children, and then they go on and do whatever they are doing. They're using the iPad, they're using their iPhone, whatever it may be, it's a pacifier for their children. You give them this iPad, the kids in the back seat, they shut up. So that's good for the parents, but they're not regulating what they watch. Neither do they type in Frozen, Elsa, whatever. Things that the parents universally know is Disney, is good, is wholesome. This is the stuff that comes up in the related videos. This is the stuff that comes up in the next autoplay videos. This might even be the video that the parents click on by mistake, not understanding or not paying attention. And this is happening. And this is happening a lot. And I see kids every day. I go to Walmart, I go to anywhere, a mall, and there's some kid, some 4-year-old, younger even. I've even had family members I've seen this happen to, are watching these little animated videos or these homemade cartoons with Superman and Elsa, and there's people wearing these suits. And I would have to say the vast majority of the time, they're inappropriate. I mean, like, again, I'm not going to say that 100% of them are bad for kids. I'm sure there are actual wholesome channels out there doing this type of either animated or real-life content, but the vast majority of it isn't, and parents just aren't paying attention. And not to mention, like I said, it's super creepy. There also is another thing could be going on here. A lot of these people are starting to say, I feel a lot of comments out there, that this is has to do with, like, pedophilia. Like, a lot of these, like, animated cartoons are, like, little girls peed on, you know, they have these pranks, they call them, drinking pee, being stepped on. And a lot of them are pornographic in nature, and it's really, really creepy. Meantime, videos on my channel, which are completely, completely fine. There's no guidelines. There's not swearing. I've had tons of videos be demonetized and lose out on. I've lost out on thousands of dollars over the last 5 months because I've had videos demonetized. I got a lot of those videos back, but in that time span, they're most of the views that they were going to get, they had already gotten, and I had missed out on monetization. There's one video in particular, I lost out on like 500,000 views in a day and a half, and then it finally got monetization back, and then it did like 20,000 the rest of its life cycle. So that's right there, it could be $1,000 I missed out on, if not more, which sucks. But these videos are all monetized for the most part. I've watched a lot of these videos, and I've gotten ads. I have YouTube Red on my personal account, but I've gone onto a separate computer, and I'd say 3 out of 10 of these videos are monetized, and I've seen ads on, and they are obscene. They're right in the title. Pee, prank, bathtub, take off clothes. Elsa takes off clothes, and just look in the thumbnail. There's boobs in the thumbnail. There's people peeing on each other in the thumbnail. And yet, these are the videos that YouTube deems monetizable. These are the ones that they put the high-dollar ads on. And not the only to mention, I didn't get into this yet, some of these videos are being featured on YouTube Kids, which is an app specifically designed to take out things bad for children. It is an app that it was specifically designed for parents to put on their tablet, to put in their kids' hands, and then they would have a guarantee that everything that's on that app, on that YouTube Kids app, would be family-friendly. Well, a lot of these are making their way on there, and because they're becoming so popular on there, they're getting hundreds and thousands and millions of views because they're on this YouTube Kid app. YouTube is promoting this, and it's just, it blows my mind. It blows my mind. I have 200,000 subscribers, right? And lately, as of the last two months or so, my channel has gotten just completely pushed to the back. Like, I'm putting out videos that I put 10, 15 hours of work into, of editing, writing, shooting, and they're getting less than 2,000 views. 2,000 views out of my 200,000. Am I complaining? A little bit. It happens. It will bounce back, hopefully. If not, we'll see what happens. But at the same time, they're pushing this. YouTube is deciding to push, you know, Spider-Man pisses on Joker's face, cum, baby joke, injection, pedophilia, bullshit, over actual content like mine. And that is very upsetting. It's very upsetting to me as a professional YouTuber to see this type of crap happening, and it just kind of just going through the cracks. I mean, YouTube claims they're aware of the situation now and are working to fix it. But I still see these videos, and I see them every day. I follow these tags now, and I see new videos every day. And I see them, have advertisements on them. Some of them are even sponsored by major companies. I've seen product placement ads for Coca-Cola, M&M, Starbucks. The list goes on. And while that specific video that they're mentioned in may not be hypersexual, that channel most likely has had hypersexual videos along the way that kids will click on after they watch that Coca-Cola ad. It's insane. Meanwhile, my video about Nintendo or about, you know, PS4 games going on sale for Black Friday, demonetized. Can't make a cent because who knows why. Maybe if I just take my dick out and piss on a child, YouTube will take notice of my channel and boost me to the front. Who knows? I really don't know. I don't know what to do about this other than I'm just trying to get, right now, I'm trying to do is try to make people aware of this. And by spreading awareness of this, hopefully we can do something about this. I mean, it has been brought to YouTube's attention. They have spoken out about this and now they're trying to fix it. But as of right now, the wheels are turning real slowly. But by hopefully informing you, by informing other people, by sharing this video, we can do something about this. Hopefully we can do something about this. These videos should all not only be demonetized, they should be blacklisted. They should be removed. These are not appropriate. These are not appropriate for any age. This is straight up sexual content disguised and Trojan horsed as kid friendly. And it's insane. It should be taken down and at the very least demonetized. But I think it should be completely delisted, pulled off as inappropriate content, sexual content, lewd content, and pulled and banned. Channels like this should be receiving bans, strikes, all kinds of guidelines, stuff they're breaking, but nope, YouTube refuses to do anything about this. Absolutely insane. Let me know what you guys think about this. Have you guys seen this going around? Also, like I said, please do me a massive favor, like this video, share this video so we can get this information out. Tell parents, if you don't want any parents that have small children, please inform them. Let them know that there are at least inform them that there are things like this out there that they should be checking for to be sure what their kids are watching is appropriate, because it is hard to tell sometimes. And if you get that related video and hit the next and hit the next and hit the next, the kids can go down a wormhole real quick and end up on, you know, Joker pissing on Elsa's face with like that, because YouTube wants them to watch it, because YouTube is making a lot of money off of them, because the ads are there, because the views are there, because it's sexual content for little kids, and it's absolutely insane. But that's all I have for today, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Like I said, like the video, share the video, subscribe if you're new around here for more content. Hopefully we'll get this channel turned around soon, and maybe I'll make a pissing video. Who knows? All right, guys. Till then, guys, take it easy, and peace!